Hello friends, welcome to this video on quadrilaterals. In the previous video, we discussed the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Today, we will solve some questions related to that topic only. So let's start. In quadrilateral PQRS, angle P, angle Q, angle R and angle S are in the ratio of 1:2:3:4. Find the measure of all its angles. Friends, assume that the measure of angle P, angle Q, angle R and angle S is x, 2x, 3x and 4x respectively. And we know that the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Therefore, angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S equals 360 degrees. We can also write this as x plus 2x plus 3x plus 4x equals 360 degrees. The sum of the left side will be 10x. Solving it, we will get x equals 36 degree. We have got the measure of x, that is the measure of angle P. With the help of this, we can find the measure of the remaining angles. The measurement of the remaining angles will be as follows. The measurement of angle P, angle Q, angle R and angle S will be 36, 72, 108 and 144 degrees respectively. You can add all these angles and see that their sum will be 360 degrees. Let us see another similar question. The ratio of the angles of the quadrilateral EFGH is given as follows. Construct a quadrilateral based on the given ratio and describe its type. Friends, using this hint, try to solve this question on your own. Let's move on to the next question. In quadrilateral ABCD, the measure of angle B is 2 times the measure of angle A, and the measure of angle D is 3 times the measure of angle C. And the sum of angles A and C is 105 degrees. Then find the measure of each angle. Friends, is there a need to draw a figure here? No. We can solve this question without drawing any figure. We are given that the measure of angle B is 2 times the measure of angle A. So, if we take angle A as X, then angle B will be 2X. Similarly, the measure of angle D is 3 times the measure of angle C. So if we take angle C as Y, then angle D will be 3Y. It is also given that angle A plus angle C is equal to 105 degrees. Angle A and angle C can also be written as X and Y in this way. Let us call this equation 1. We know that the sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Let's call this equation 2. Now by putting the values of angles A, B, C and D in equation 2, we will get. If you simplify it a bit, you will get. Let us call it equation 3. Friends, we can write equation 3 like this as well. Now, by placing the value of equation 1 in it, we can find the value of Y. We got Y equal to 45 degrees. Now, by putting the value of Y in equation 1, we can find the value of X. That is, angle A is equal to X is equal to 60 degrees and angle C is equal to Y is equal to 45 degrees. And angle B and angle D will be as follows. Angle B equals 120 degrees, angle D equals 135 degrees. Thus, we got the measurement of all the angles. Friends, that's all in this session. Today, we solved some questions related to the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. In the next session, we will discuss some facts related to this topic. Thank you.